need impulse power now! Run. Hey everybody, this is Michael again, and welcome back to my channel here on YouTube. Well guys, I'm back at it, continuing my look at all 28 original Japanese versions of the Godzilla films. Well guys, I know it's been probably about 2 weeks since I last actually took a look at the Godzilla films or continued my reviews in this series, and most of you probably know that's because I've been working really, really hard on the Star Trek fan film. We actually got it made and actually shown it at a convention here in town. It's on the internet now, so if any of you guys are interested in watching the film, just type in Starship Valiant Legacy and you will find it. But today's film is the 17th movie in the Godzilla franchise, and that film is Godzilla vs. Biollante. And this is the DVD of the film itself, guys. I actually have the DVD of this, and I have the Blu-ray of the film itself. This is put out by Echo Bridge, guys. And I gotta tell you, I've shown this before, but I really like the cover on this, guys. And it's actually the same as on the Blu-ray. But the cover for this is really, really nice. I really love it. And even the back is pretty doggone awesome, guys. Love the cover for this film. Show you the inside of it, guys. There we go. Pretty much more of the same. I'll show you guys the Blu-ray, which is, like I said, the same. Same on the front and the same on the back. And the disc itself is also the same. I will say, guys, that this Blu-ray and the DVD, coincidentally, actually have a couple of making of features on the film, which, you know, as far as Godzilla home releases go, most of the time you don't get anything. There's a ton of making of material on these films, but you don't get anything on these films. Anything, for the most part, on the making of these movies, which is really, really sad, you know, because the Godzilla films have a rich, very, very rich history as far as making of material goes. And I could just imagine, from what I've seen, what little I've seen, that making of material on these films would really, really be great. And it's something that should be included more on these films, guys, because really, really interesting stuff. But this one actually comes with a making of Godzilla vs. Biollante, which is over 40 minutes of making of material, guys. 40 minutes. And of course it's in the original Japanese language, and we get it in subtitles, which is fine. And then we have behind the design, so two making of features on the film itself, which is Echo Bridge. They usually release bargain DVDs or home releases, and you know, guys, it's been so long since I've actually made a video that actually just talking in my normal voice, it's making my throat itch. So that tells you there, it's been a while. But as far as Echo Bridge goes, guys, these are pretty nice releases, I would have to say. Nice releases. Now, unfortunately, guys, I'm going to go into the Blu-ray just a little bit. You know, I have a limited amount of time. But the Blu-ray release of Godzilla vs. Biollante, as far as picture quality go, is pretty subpar. It's just, to me, a little bit better than the DVD release of the film. As a matter of fact, there's really nothing outstanding as far as picture quality goes in this release. First time on Blu-ray, it says, but definitely not the best of times. And that's kind of sad, guys, because, you know, you get this format, Blu-ray format, gets a pretty bad rap these days, you know, as far as, you know, a lot of people won't collect DVD anymore, for the simple fact that they consider Blu-ray to be a much better format. And technically speaking, Blu-ray should be a better format, but a lot of lackluster releases goes into these Blu-ray releases today, guys. They're not living up to the standards that they're perceived to be. They're not living up to the standard that this format has to offer, and that's really sad, because to me, it's one of those things where, like, your grandpa used to tell you when you were a kid, if you're not going to do it right, don't do it at all. And that's pretty much how I feel about Blu-ray. For the most part, you get just a little bit better release as far as Blu-ray versus DVD in a lot of cases. I mean, that's not to say that some Blu-rays aren't good or great, because they are. But as far as, you know, these films goes, and it's not just the Blu-ray of this film, but many of the Blu-ray releases of the Godzilla films that we have, King Kong vs. Godzilla, and some of the other ones are just subpar releases. And, you know, I've got several releases in my collection on Blu-ray, and for the most part, those releases by Kraken are better than this release. And this is a newer film, but it's really a subpar release, guys. If you're expecting this to have great picture quality, you are sorely going to be disappointed, because it does not. Now, Godzilla vs. Biollante, guys, was directed by Kazuki Ōmori. And this director would go on to direct one more film in the Godzilla franchise, and that was the wildly popular Godzilla vs. King Ghidorah. And I actually saw this film, guys, the very first time, you know, after Godzilla 1985, after that film, I wasn't even aware that they were making any more Godzilla films, because Toho stopped releasing the films in the States. And I can remember one of the reasons being, you know, other than the film not being a real success, and I don't know if this is a rumor or not, but I remember reading that Toho decided not to release any more Godzilla films because American audiences pretty much laughed at Godzilla 1985. They laughed at the effects, the dubbing was terrible, and it was just kind of like a big joke to American audiences because of the special effects, and, you know, how we were just a little bit better as far as special effects goes in our films. So Toho was kind of like, you know, we're not going to release our films to an American audience if they're just going to laugh at the films and disrespect the films and all that. So that was a reason that, other than monetary, but that was one of the major reasons that I heard that Toho decided not to release any more Godzilla films. Now, I saw this on HBO, believe it or not, for the first time, and it was actually put out by Miramax, and this is also the Miramax release of the film, which has really a dreadful dubbing in English for this film. And as a matter of fact, one of the biggest annoyances about the English dub on this film, guys, is that the Japanese characters in the film don't even know how to pronounce Godzilla. They say Godzilla. Godzilla. I'm like, my goodness. You're dubbing a Godzilla film and you don't even know how to say Godzilla? Now, not all the characters do that, but, you know, there's a couple of characters that every time they say Godzilla, it's Godzilla. But Godzilla vs. Biollante, guys, came about by producer Tomoyuki Tanaka, who wanted a new monster for Godzilla to fight. He didn't want to go back to the older monsters. He didn't want to, you know, bring back King Ghidorah or Mothra or any of the old characters. One of the new characters. So he held this contest where 500 people entered the contest to create some kind of creature for Godzilla to fight. And the lucky winner was actually a dentist who was also a part-time screenwriter. And he created Biollante. And Tanaka was happy with the creature that was created. I mean, a plant creature was something that we'd never been treated to in the Godzilla franchise. So he wrote a draft for the story, which was ultimately, by the time the picture came to the screen, was changed drastically. There were still elements from his original screenplay, but lots of elements had been changed. Now, first and foremost, in Godzilla vs. Biollante, he actually fights a earlier version of Biollante, which is actually like a big rose with teeth. In the original screenplay, now, you know, Dr. Shiragami created Biollante by crossing Godzilla cells with a plant. But originally, in the original draft, Dr. Shiragami created a fish and rat hybrid creature using Godzilla cells. And that was the actual first creature that Godzilla fought. But ultimately, that was excised from the film. And we got the rose version of Biollante. And then we got the actual creature version of Biollante. I gotta say, guys, that, you know, Godzilla vs. Biollante is, to me, when I first saw the film, it had kind of a different tone to it. It was very, very different from the Godzilla films that I was used to. The musical score, I would probably have to say, even though the score has grown on me after all these years, it's probably the weakest link in the film. The Godzilla suit itself was miles above the suit used in Godzilla 1985. As a matter of fact, this was a really lifelike suit. And just the story itself, it was kind of poetic, just so different from anything that we had seen before that a lot of fans didn't accept it. They didn't like the movie, but I enjoyed it. I really think that Godzilla vs. Biollante is a very, very underrated film with some, actually, you know, as far as characters go, not developed characters, but they do have some very likable characters in the film. And, you know, the special effects, this probably has one of my favorite special effects sequences in the film, and that's when Godzilla's fighting the military on the water. And he's fighting these ships, and you see these, they're using actual models mixed in with real ships firing, and it's one of the most expertly blended scenes in a Godzilla film. I really like that scene. It's just really, really epic. And this film also introduced the psychic kid, Mickey, in the film series. And I've always been a fan of Mickey. She went on to star in every Godzilla film after this one, up to the Hentai ending, to the Millennium series. And I really enjoyed her. I always liked her as a character. So, you know, there was a lot in this film that I like. You know, the actual process of having a psychic trying to communicate with Godzilla, where ultimately she forms a bond with Godzilla. You know, I remember in a later film, she kind of says something like, you know, he's got feelings too. And, you know, so it added a nice human touch to Godzilla, having the psychic bond with him. But ultimately, guys, Godzilla vs. Biollante is a film that I really enjoyed. And I got to say that it's probably one of my favorites in the series. And I really enjoyed it. Just some brilliant monster effects, some brilliant lifelike effects that bring Godzilla to life. And, you know, many times after this film, the effects on Godzilla being lifelike weren't as creative as this movie. So Godzilla vs. Biollante is definitely, like I said, guys, one of my favorites in the film series. And I definitely, most definitely got to recommend it. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Take care, and I shall see you in the next Godzilla film review. Thanks for watching.